Okay, let's do this. I can more than four. Let's try five. Okay, no, I'm not like a python. Don't judge me. It's Anzac Day. Good day to my lovely subscribe. Oh my God, I've got Anzac cookie in my nose. And I'm here at work. I'm spreading Australian love with my Anzac cookies. I mean biscuits, not cookies. That's American. This is Anzac Day. We gotta stop this onslaught of cultural imperialism. One cookie at a time. Except Moana. Moana can stay. Moana's cool. I'm handing out Anzac biscuits today, which was the idea of the new owner of the cafe that I work at. And I've met a family. So sweet. The dad's like, such a dad. You know what I mean? Bless. The youngest daughter is so sweet. Oldest one, I meant to be showing around. She must have got a better offer because she's wandered off. No idea where she is. I think she might be a bit of a troublemaker, that one.
Whoa, who was that? That was not me. I sound like my mother.
Any minute now, I'm gonna start raging.
Piper Mary Willis!
I'm not gonna lie, I have been known to be like, Anzac Day, yes, day off. This year's different. Handing out these Anzac biscuits has really made me properly think about the day's meaning and the importance of it. And especially now, the world that we live in is just, I don't even know where to begin. Whole nother video rant. I just think that like now, more so than any other time in history, I think it's important that we look at the world and not just our own, but like everyone else's perspective, you know? Walk a mile in everyone else's shoes. That's what really causes war, right? It's differences, differences in values or beliefs. You know, today, like doing stuff like this, like handing out these delicious homemade treats. I got the opportunity to go out there and meet new people, listen to them and hear a different perspective I got to see today. And I got a chance to understand them, which I think we all need to do and it's important. Oh my God, they're so good, Dippy. On that note, let me tell you about three individuals that I met today. Numero uno is T-Bone. Now, just bear with, he is a backpacker. T-Bone, what kind of name is T-Bone? And trust me, I had the exact same reaction. Curious, and I did a bit of snooping behind the old reception desk. Illegal, perhaps. But, believe it or not, shocker, his name isn't actually T-Bone, it's a nickname. Whoa. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me, Terrence. If someone came up to me and they were like, yo, my name's T-Bone, I'd be like, whisperitas that away. I was actually very surprised. He's super smart. Like, he made this point the other day. If you take away arts in school, for example, that actually has more of an effect on how people view the world than if you took away history. Because art is perspective. Art is how we view the world. It's like a representation of how we view the world. So essentially, art is us. My mind was blown. He's so smart. Individual dos. He was a real DJC. That's what I like to call a dad joke central. Not a word of a lie. This is how our conversation went. Hi, my name's Piper. I'm handing out Anzac biscuits today on behalf of Harold's Cafe. Would you like one? Piper, did you say? Oh, well, then these biscuits don't look finished. Sorry? If you're a Piper, then maybe you should have piped some icing on these biscuits. Haha, you're hilarious. Yes. Anzac Day has taught me a lot about being tolerant of others. Different kinds of people. Individual numero tres. Just before I met this amazing woman named Pfizer and she moved to Australia only a few years ago. When I was talking to her, I thought that she might be a bit lost as to what Anzac Day was all about, but there was just so much graciousness. She appreciated the day so much because she believes that it shows that Australia cares about the lives and the stories of its people. I guess it's like a bad reflection on me, but I wasn't expecting it. I'm not mad that I'm working on Anzac Day, let's just put it that way.
Okay guys, thank you so much for watching today's episode. And until next time, farewell my worldly warriors. Bye bye. Oop, crumbs. Yeah.